Today we are going to be painting this yellow rose in a vase from a photo which I took at a friend of mine's house.
The background I'm going to do a light grey, so I've put some water in there. I'm going to pick up some ultramarine. Add a little touch of burnt sienna to it. And then before I paint, I'm going to check to see the colour that I want. It's a light blue-grey. I want just enough contrast to show up the yellow rose, which is slightly yellow, or a light yellow, it's also a light colour. So I may darken this a little bit more. We can check that. Now that's a bit more grey and not too blue. Okay, I'm happy with that. So let's start with a wash. Let's make sure I've got enough bead. We stir it. I'm always watching that side as well, so I don't lose that bead. Stir it, come back to this one. Three places to look at this stage. Not putting too much water on my brush. Get into there. Come nicely around. Let me just get a bead. Yeah, where the leaf is, I'm going to go, no, maybe rather not. I'll keep with the, because I want to put a yellow background or a yellow underwash for the leaves. Here. for all practical purposes, for the very dark leaves, you can actually do the background over it, but I'm just going to carry on and leave the everything in white, clear paper. Pick up some of that carefully into there, lift up some of that, won't leave the bead too long, otherwise you have a little bit, you can hardly see it though, but there's a line there. I left that one a little bit too long. Always mix up the paint. If there's any sedimentary paint, the granules are going to separate, and we don't want that. I'll come back and do the inside. The larger area is much more important at this stage than the little areas. If you really have a problem, you can actually mask out with masking fluid the areas, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go straight onto the edges. You can see I mixed up way too much, overestimated, but rather mix up too much when you're doing a wash than too little, because the moment you run out of a wash, you'll never get the same mix, and also your paper dries in the meantime. When you come back and you really get streaking. Soak up. I'm just touching the liquid, not really onto the paper. We've got a reasonable background. background. A little damage mark on the paper, but we can always cover that up if necessary. It may be dark now. When it dries, it must get lighter. If not, we just put another little leaf over the top. Always do a little bit of a disguise. Now I need to come in between. I need not quite so much heavy water. Just careful I don't get my hand onto there. So let's go into here. Just a little bit of patience and you can get this all done. If it's still a bit damp and it's a little bit light, you can always drop in a bit more colour. More of the background, let me just see that I've got everything. This area here, I'm going to put a very light... Oops, I don't want it that much. Just a light hint of the background in here. I'm going to put the wall at the back is going to be a slight shadow of this onto the back. The light is coming from this area in this direction here, or from that direction, coming down like that. So take some of this, but I don't want it too dark. I'm just going to put a bit here. A little bit more water with it. Just test it against that. And it mustn't be watery. Too watery, that's the problem. So I'm going to have to... You know, let's take some of that. Get some of the pigment. Get most of the water off. Fell on the floor. Just want to get touch that water and slowly build up. There's a bit of a darker area. Thank you. Just a light shadow. I don't want it too heavy. Just an indication gives it that three-dimensional effect. Right, now I'm going to clean up. Let me clean this area here so I can get the yellow in. I want it to keep it as clean as possible. So let's go in. Oops, I don't want to. Clean water. In the brush. And I'm going to use some lemon yellow. Just to give a light wash. Now the check the leaves have a light yellow color behind it, so let's start building up. We start from light through to dark. And while we edit, we have this one coming down here. Check this color. Much too bright. So we turn him down with a little touch of red. Check it out. Right, there we're getting the more or less the color that I want. So now I'm not using a lot of water. Bring that into there. Mix up a little bit at a time as I need it. Actually, I'm going to just get rid of all this water here. Piece of kitchen towel for us to use and keep it here on the side. Okay, now I need a little touch of red into that. I'm always going to text first before I put that on. Okay, so let's more to the leaf. Very light touch. At the tip of the brush, I'm blocking in, and where I need to, I can later lift out some of the lighter areas. Just been working very carefully. I can go to a smaller brush, but I can go with this as much as what I can. Always use a bigger brush, the biggest brush that you can use. And you go to a smaller one when you need to. Now I'm darkening the green with red. Red is the opposite color. And that neutralizes the green. So here, it gives you that very darker green. So let's go here. I'm trying to get this little tip. I'm making this dark green, then I'm going to come and lift out where I need to, but it must dry first. I'm not using masking fluid, but if you're worried about that, you can always mask out where you need to. Darken this area down here a bit. It's still wet. You can drop some of this in and it merges nicely. Got some shadow of that coming into here. I'm going to lift some of that out. And then drop a little more of the dark color in here. On the shadow side. Some other greens down here. I'll come into that later. So I'm making slowly, mixing a little bit at a time. They don't have to be all equal. All the leaves have their own. It can be too boring if you keep them all exactly the same color. Let me zoom into the leaf area and you can see better what I'm doing. Let me get a smaller brush for lifting out the small areas. Lift out some of the sunlit areas. Notice I've left a little line, open line there, so that this does not bleed into the other. In watercolours you can actually leave that open, nobody's going to worry about it. If you're worried, you can always come back when it's 100% dry, just with a damp brush, and then you just blend it in together. Okay. But later on I will be coming in with a smaller brush, but at the moment I want to use the bigger brush as much as possible. Okay, and the rose leaves have the little serrated edge, so we're going to add this in. Nice point. To this area. This has orange in here. We will darken it up as it comes. This is just the underpainting. Touches in here. Right, I think what we do while I'm in this area, we've got the red rose sort of just sticking out the back, and we use some alizarin crimson. just gives you that nice little bit of bright red as opposed to the yellow that will be coming in to the into the rose, which I'm going to do later on. Take a bit of yellow ochre, and it's in these yellow ochre is the shadow color for cadmium yellow. And get some covered in a bit too much there, but it doesn't matter. Nobody's gonna notice, they're gonna there's some yellow ochre in here. A lot of people say you don't like Chinese white in your paintings, but as long as you're not mixing Chinese white with your colors, there's not a problem at all. This is just giving me some nice little highlights. Not too heavy in these ones, just a hint. That's a little bit too thick, so I'm just thin that down. using this lemon yellow, so I'm gonna, I want it nice and clean, so let's get some of that out. To put a light wash right over this. That's my base, so let's get a bit of a bigger brush. And this is the highlight colour. Using a little flat brush. There we go. Now I'm going to make this rose a little bit darker. Then the photo. You don't have to always keep exactly the same. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start from the outside and then work my way in. Some shadow in here. Actually, a little bit too light. Because what is happening here, the sun is coming from this side, it's hitting the tips of the petals, which are sticking out, and these petals are throwing a shadow. There's one throwing a shadow across there, this one is throwing a shadow here, this one is throwing a shadow there, this one is throwing a shadow there. So you need to do that to lift out. So at the moment, just placing, and I can do some blending later on. I want to first get my tonal ranges, my lights and my darks. And that helps you later on when you doing your blending, you know where you are. So there's a light shadow. This is petal here is curling over. There's a very light shadow inside here. A deeper shadow in there. deeper shadows on this side, because the light is here and then the shadow on there. So the shadows on this side here are going to be very much less. It's forming. I'm going to get a smaller brush, and I'm going to be using some yellow ochre. But before I do that, I'm wetting the brush, and I'm going to blend that into there. With a damp brush. This is not the final shadow. Just softening that edge. Just softening it. It bends, fades away into there. You just need to be careful of not losing the highlight area. You want to get that, just soften the edge. You must have a hard edge and a soft edge. A hard edge and a soft edge. So I'm just softening those edges. Softening them. Right, now I'm coming with some yellow ochre. Now the yellow ochre is the shadow color of this, of cadmium yellow. Now if you take, the opposite of cadmium yellow is violet. And if you take, mix up some alizarin crimson or red with some blue, and get your violet color, and you add a touch of that into your cadmium yellow, you will get yellow ochre. So let's darken up these little areas here. I can always do some blending, so I'm going to come right up against this edge. Because you want to have that hard edge. And a deeper shadow here. I'm going to blend this these ones. I'm going to blend upwards. Thing here is to carefully have a look and see where these are. You need it's your hard edges and your soft edges. Your hard edges and your soft edges. Soften these edges. And what I do to damp it, to soften it properly, is you dampen the area next to it and then bring that into that damp area, and it softly fades in without getting a hard edge. So I'm going to just dampen the area, not right, just next up to it, and then I bring the damp up into that area, and then it gets that nice fade, even fading. And there's some much darker areas in here. Deep shade. Dampen my brush, dampen the side, bring that in. Clean the brush, dampen the side, and bring that in. This one is a hard edge, it's right deep in the shadow area. Some see, I've brought out that little indent in the leaf, and that what also makes it a bit more realistic. This leaf is turning up. So I'm going to get that there. Wet the side. Come down. And then blend into that. So I can bring some of that up. You see that curl of the of the petal. I'm going to drop some darker colour in here while it's still damp. Also, this edge here also has got a rounding, so you'll still have a very much lighter shadow along the top here. So we'll just give it a little bit. And a little bit down here. Anything that's round, the light's coming, you get your highlight area, and as it goes around it gets darker, and as it goes around it gets darker. So on the edges, anything round, the edges will be slightly darker. So just do a little bit in here, but there, and this here will sort of come round and out. So as it points out this side, it'll also have a bit of a shadow area in here. You don't see it in the painting, but I'm doing it to add a bit more of a realistic feel to this. You can always come back and work that a bit more. Let's get this into here. And the center area is going to be always a little bit darker than the rest. And I'm going to darken this up here a bit more than normal. So you have an area where it draws the eye into the center. Come back into this area later on. Just give a little bit of a shadow here for the lip. Very light, but just enough to show the highlight on the rounding. I'll come back later into the rose. Here we have get the idea of what's going on. Now we're going to go into the vase. Now we need to first check and see what color is going to be here, because that color is going to reflect up into the vase. So let's I think I'm going to make a dark table. So I'm going to put a light. What shall I put? We can leave it white, and it'll show a very light grey. And let's make that light grey again, which is a bit of blue, a little touch of burnt sienna. Make it very watery. And I can always tone it down. That will reflect a little bit of this colour up in the side, especially along here. But I'll drop that in a bit later. So what I'm going to do is very light blue. It's transparent. And we've got this light blue. I'll do it a little bit more. Green can go over the blue. I just want to make the vase stand out a little bit more then. In the background. I want a little touch of this. Here's that grey that I had here. Bringing some of this colour up into there. The leaves and darker colour is going to be it's got a slight uphill here because of the rounding of the bottom and the distortion of the glass. You're looking at a low angle and that come in here. A touch of the Payne's grey, which you can also mix with ultramarine blue and burnt sienna. That blue-grey. I'm going to take that. Do here. And get this green stem that's coming down. them is the Arc Burnt Sienna from this stem that's coming down here. I don't want it too dark. This is a bit more maroon. And it takes some bit of alizarin crimson into here. And bring this alizarin crimson down. It is part of that. Shadow there under the lip of the... Now inside here we have little side reflections that come in, so there's little... This very light glaze in here. I'm going to give a light burnt sienna glaze over this table. Just light, so it'll complement these going in there. And that's going to be very much darker, so let's just darken that while I'm about it. Also a bit of roughness here on the... I'm going to add some detail in there. Burnt sienna is a dark orange, so a bit of yellow is not going to make much difference in there. Just give it a nice little, like a mahogany touch. Just gives an earth colour down to, on the bottom here. There we go. I need a bit more than this. Bright colour. Hopefully that should be enough. Let's put a bit more water. Okay, here goes. bead here. So I'll come around the other side. Let that dry. When it's 100% dry and I've done all the rest, I'll turn it around and do another wash from here, darker one going down that way. So there we have a bit of a table. And drop it a little colour. For the shadow, it'll be a little bit darker to the edge of the table than there, so take just some of this darker colour, and the light's coming from this side, so you won't have too much on here. You'll start seeing a little bit here. And it'll sort of disappear around this side. Gives you the thickness, but now some little places have got bits and folds up in there. And what's happening here? Some shadow on this side. Let's just give a little indication of a little bit. sort of help it a little bit. Around the edge. Now, where's my Chinese white? I'm going to add a few reflections. A big mix of blue and mauve, and more blue. And I'm going to add the shadow in here now. Across the table. Just dampen that a bit so it blends a little bit better. And here when he goes across the wall, it's going to have a little bit of a darker and then fade away a bit out through to the top. So I'm going to have to do this also very carefully. Some water, blend that in. It doesn't have to be absolutely perfect, because you also have some, all these little stems and stuff shining through on there. the darker areas. I think that's... And I'm going to add some highlights. Into there and along the edges. Just along the tips. There's some places where I can come back and darken up the shadows a little bit. And that brings out some nice highlights. I'm going to put a thorn on here. I'm going to put a thorn there. So let's sticking out the other side. Just a little pointer that points up into there. Now I'm going to come and add some darker shadows in. And I'm going to be doing it with some of this color. Very lightly. Right in the under the edges. Get this water to drop off there. Darken the shadow up here a bit. I want to darken up these center bits here to draw the eye in. soften that out a bit. Just need to bring this petal out a little bit more. Just give it a bit more shadow on the curl. This is deep shadow inside here. So I'm emphasizing this petal a little bit more. The colour that I'm using here is the crimson and the blue. You see that violet and a bit of more violet into your yellow ochre just that gives you a deeper yellow ochre. That's basically what I'm doing here. I don't want to put too much on that side. I need to catching these highlights. Blend this in a little bit better here. Wet the side. Come in. Soften this edge. That. And I'm going to make it a darker wash. And in here, and I don't want to put too much water to get quite a bit of pigment. So I'm going to take quite a bit of burnt sienna. Do that. And I think that colour on its own should be quite nice. Across there. I think that should do. Or maybe just a touch of blue. Just a slightly touch. Burnt sienna is a dark orange, and opposite orange is a blue. So if you want to darken up your orange, your burnt sienna or your orange, add a little touch of blue to it. Okay, and I've loaded my brush and doing it across. I want to get that bead before I go down. Need to get a bead across here. And I need my tissue in the hand just in case I need it. From here, I'm just going to get very light. Very light. This is just with a little bit of water. Just bring that in. Going to get some colour out here. Give you that slight bit of a reflection. And a little bit damp. Just need to take the tape off. And to do that, we need the hairdryer. Always pull away, don't pull upwards, pull sideways, and I'm going to use a hairdryer to soften the glue, and as you pull it, watch where underneath to see that you're not ripping up any paper, and pull away, because if it does rip, you're going to rip the paper away from your painting and not into your painting and damage all the work that you've been doing. So let me just get that up here to get that started. And it's also on a low heat. Now here in this corner, right here, is very small, but there is a little bit of a paper rip right in that corner. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the back of my nail, and I'm going to just burnish that, burnishing the fibers back into place. Here we go. Nobody's going to see that. So there we have our finished painting.